Indraprastha Gas reported an inline set of earnings for the December quarter. Double-digit volume growth and rise in unit margins were the key factors that aided the quarter gone by. Soumit Sarkar had a chat with the Managing Director, ES Ranganathan, and began by asking him about the key drivers behind the volumes growth. Listen in.
We should be actually maintaining this double-digit growth for the fourth quarter of this year also and going forward in the next year also, because CNG has been, the demand has been quite robust because of the price differential with petrol and diesel. And in the industrial sector, there has been a ban on polluting fuels like petcoke and furnace oil. So which brings more and more industries under the gas umbrella. Plus, we have also acquired more than 357 commercial customers during the last 1 year.
Also, your unit margins, that is the EBITDA per SCM, now that expanded by nearly 8% compared to last year. So I guess this is because of the price hikes taken by the company and because of some cost moderation that we had seen in the third quarter. However, starting Q4, rupee has depreciated while the Singapore LNG prices have come off a bit. So how do you see this unit margins to be in the fourth quarter of financial year 2019?
You see, all through in our formula, we have been keeping a target of 5.75 to 6 for EBITDA. And, it varies when, when the time for passing through any increase or decrease in the cost of gas or the rupee exchange rate. So that thing, if we are doing it promptly, then we should be touching more near to 6 than 5.75.
Okay. On the expansion front, sir, how many outlets did you open? How many outlets do you plan to open in the fourth quarter? And any targets that you have set for financial year 2020?
Yeah, we should be opening. We have opened around 25 now. And by the end of the year, we should be opening a new 50 outlets for CNG.
So you're aiming to open nearly 25 outlets in the fourth quarter?
Yes, yes.
And for the financial year 2020, how many outlets have you set any target for that?
We are looking at a target in excess of 50, somewhere in the range of 60 maybe.
Okay. And how has been the private car conversion rate and what would support the volume growth for Indraprastha Gas going forward?
There has been, conversion of at least 4,000 cars per month that we have seen. And then there has been conversion of, LMVs and trucks due to the imposition of green tax by the Pollution Control National Green Tribunal. So this has, this is a very healthy sign for increase in the CNG numbers.
Okay. On the Haryana city's Gurgaon asset, now I remember last quarter you couldn't share much details, but any further details that you could share with us on the valuations, on the acquisition cost that you can share now with us? Any details?
No, valuation is still going on. Deloitte is doing the valuation. They are yet to come up with a final figure. And the next hearing is on 25th February. We should hear something before that.
But then any estimations from your side on the valuations or the acquisition cost?
No. We will let Deloitte do the numbers.
Okay. Lastly, sir, the 10th round of city gas auction is expected to start soon. So any goals that the company has set, any areas that you might be keen to acquire?
So we have bid for 15 geographical areas, mostly in central and western UP and Haryana and Punjab. Plus, we have also put in some bid for the major cities that has come up in the south of India.